Okay, so when you first go to the relationship dashboard of your saved project on Node3x, all you'll see are lots of blue dots, and each of these blue dots represents a person posting one post. Now, that's fine, but as you see, we don't really see any forms of engagement on these, so we can't see which ones are popular through reshares or plus ones or comments. We can, however, see that who the person is, and we can click on a link to see what the post is relating to, etc. Okay, so the first thing we're actually going to do is to update all of these posts to show all of the engagements. And what we do from here is click on that updates link, it drops down, and then you have a little drop down menu, select engagement update, and then click update. From there, after you've waited a while, you'll be sent an email notification from Node3x saying that the engagements have actually updated. Do wait to receive this email, basically because it will actually then tell you that everything is up to date. You can, however, load it interim to get a snapshot of where Node3x is up to in terms of collecting all the relevant forms of engagement. But after you've received that email, just click on the load button again, and you'll see then that the graph relationship will change to reflect the engagements it's collected surrounding each of the posts. So once the relations UI is refreshed, you can see that the picture is now very different. Beforehand, we had lots of blue dots, and now we have lots of multicolored dots and lots of lines called edges. And this, at first instance, doesn't make a lot of sense. So what we need to do is to sort this picture out so that it does start to make sense. Now, in the first instance, we may not want to have all the different forms of engagements actually showing. And here's a good opportunity just to explain what each of the nodes actually mean, or the color of the nodes actually mean. If we select the graph statistics area, we can see we've got a little legend here explaining what each one is. And if we highlight over with the mouse, we can see that blue is activity, meaning the original post. The purple is comments. The greens are reshares, and the orange are plus ones. And we can see predominantly within this graph itself that the over the populated area of nodes is formed by plus ones. So let's just have a look at those plus ones on their own within the graph. Let's say you want to do this because you want to circle everybody that's plus oned a piece of content but nobody else. So we're going to deselect the comments and reshares, which is it within the manage graph at the top. And then we're just going to click on the load button again. Now, the only nodes that we have within the viewer here are the original posts and also plus ones. But it still looks a little bit messy, so now let's organize this into something which is a little bit easier to understand. From here, down in the bottom right-hand corner of the graph, you can see a little control panel, which becomes a little bit more apparent when you mouse over it. What you actually want to do is hit the green play button here. And then you'll start to see that the nodes within the graph are reorganizing themselves in relation to each of the posts. What that actually means is that it finds the node closest to where it originates from. For example, if Jeremy plus oned a piece of my content, and he also plus oned a piece of James' content, then Node3x will bring it closer together and create what's called a shortest path between those two posts, just to indicate there is actually a link between us. And it doesn't take long for the graph to reorganize itself, and you can immediately see that some of the orange nodes are larger than others. Now, this is an indicator to you that this person in particular, because each node represents a person, the larger the orange node, the more plus ones they actually do on related content. So we're going to have a little look at those in a little bit more detail now. So I'm just stopping that. And just to make things even more simpler to understand, if we go back to the manage graph, what I'm actually going to do is from the graph order dropdown is select the out degree. An out degree basically says, you know, how often are these people outwardly engaging on other people's content. Excuse me. Then from there, I'm actually going to make the nodes slightly larger, just again, just to make it easier for us to see them. And the last little bits I'm going to do is to make the smallest node size 0 and click apply. And then from there, I'm just going to filter or use the filtering graph. And you can see now I'm left with a selection of nodes which have at least, or they've at least, you can see in the filter by score, they've at least engaged or plus one'd twice on other people's content. All right, we can increase that at least 3 times, at least nearly 5 times, or, you know, 6 times. So, 5.6 times. So let's just work with these for a moment. Now, from here, I'd like to actually know who they are. So let's apply some labels to them so we can see who they are. All I've done here is go to the label threshold, and you can see it's set to 12 at the moment. If I reduce that number, say down to 5, and click apply, then I can get their names. And then I can click on the zoom in. You see the graph just rearranging itself. And now I can see exactly who they are. From there then, all I'm going to do is just hover over here. I get a bit of a centrality summary. We explain what centrality is on snaphix.com, snaphix.com. But so I'm going to leave that from this little tutorial. If I want to see exactly the post they're clicking on, I'm going to click on it. And from here, I can see this is the actual post they've actually plus one'd. Now, as an example, if I view the per post activity, we're actually now viewing the official Google Plus post itself. And I can just scroll down. I can add any of these people if I so wish. And there he is. And I could add him to a circle. And here's another example. I've just reloaded the same graph, but this time showing only those people that have shared content. Now, rather than looking at it from a Google Plus official post perspective, all I'm actually going to do is to minimize the manage graph, look at the people in graph, and then go over to reshares. Now, when it says unknown, actually these are private reshares. Obviously we do not show who the people were that reshared privately. However, if we were to wanting to circle this person, all we need to do is to hover over their picture, and we can then do some basic circle management by adding them directly from the Google Plus hover card. So this has helped.